Familial searching is a tool that we can use to solve unsolved cases that have not been solved through the use of our DNA offender database, either state or nationwide. It's based on genetic principles of genetic science and statistics that derive information from profiles that may be related to the offender or to the person who left the evidence at the crime scene.
Familial searching is sort of, in our view, the elephant in the room these days. It's one of those concepts that there's both fear about and hesitancy about, and yet on a daily basis, we're reminded of the need to use whatever tools we can to solve some of the most difficult and challenging crimes that states are facing.
Familial searching, familial DNA searching, is a tool. It's another tool in the toolbox of law enforcement, and it's a tool that should be used.
Familial searching isn't the norm because I think there's not a lot of awareness in the law enforcement community of its existence.
Every single instance where familial could be used, whether there's a result or not, maybe there'll be a solve, maybe there'll be a cold case hit, and maybe one victim, and that's really all it would take, right? One victim to get some sort of justice based on a new technology or a new way to search.
Some people have suggested the cost to do this should be a deterrent, but I think the first question needs to be, who's going to assign a value to the lives of people that get lost because we're not doing it?
So the way to deal with that, in our view, is to just hit it head on. We need to start having the conversation about the role that familial searching should play in states.
The question may not be, why aren't we using familial DNA? The question may be, why aren't we using familial DNA more?